all yours, Lord. We just give our hearts, we give our lives, and surrender to you, Lord. Take our lives. And Lord, let us become just a church that loves each other. Let us become a body, Lord God, that values you, that values one another. Lord, help us this morning to become all that you want us to become. I pray this in Jesus' great name. And all God's people said,
amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Colossians chapter 3,
verse 4 this morning. I'd like to share as we're a church of worship. We love to worship God. And it's more than just a song service, but I believe song, and when we sing to the Lord and we give our hearts to Him, He inhabits those praises. Amen. So when you open up your mouth and you sing and you open up your heart, God finds that attractive, and He says, I can come dwell in that place. Amen. That's what we want. We want this to be a dwelling of God in the Spirit. Amen. For you and I.
Amen.
Amen. And so in that, though, you and I, how many know the Bible says in Hebrews that God is shaking not only the earth, He's shaking the heavens, He's shaking it all. And I know some of us, I'm even going through a shaking. There's something shaking in my life. So in the end, I might be found in Christ and in Christ alone. Amen. For the church and everything that's going on in the world, the shaking that's going on in our lives is simply so that you and I can have the right foundation. And that foundation is Jesus Christ and Him alone. Amen. We're instructed not to put our trust in the wisdom of man, but in the power of God. Jesus loves you. He died on the cross. And He will come back again. Things are fixing to get weird and crazy. But if Jesus said it, He will come back. But right now, you and I, our job, Colossians 3, it says, therefore, if you have been raised up with Christ, keep seeking the things above where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your mind on the things above, not on the things that are on earth. For you have died and your life is hidden with Christ in God. Verse 4, when Christ, who is our life, everybody say, He's my life.
He's my life.
When Christ, who is my life, is revealed, then you also will be revealed with Him in glory. And so the Apostle Paul says that Christ is our very, He's our life. Christ, as a believer, He's our life this morning. And as we worship the Lord, I simply want you to just make Him your life. Everything that you are, everything that you have, everything that we are this morning, it's all rooted and grounded in Christ alone. Amen. But He's changing us. And so it's just important this morning that you and I just give God. some furniture in your life. Rearrange some things in your life. Let him rearrange them. He's a beautiful decorator. He's a beautiful Savior and God, and he promises he only wants good for you. He promises us blessing and a future that's filled with nothing but good things. So this morning, just open up your heart and call upon him and just say, of anything other than you. You're our rock. You're our foundation, God. Nothing else matters, Lord, but having our lives founded on you. And I pray for breakthrough for my brothers and sisters, my spiritual family that are here, Lord, that are going through a brokenness. They're going through some trials. Lord, you warned us not to be surprised by the fiery ordeal among us, which comes upon us for our testing. So this morning we say we're not surprised. And so, Lord, what we're going through is simply you showing us to place our hope in our life in you and you alone, because you're coming next. We welcome change. Everybody just say, Lord, I welcome change into my life. You're changing me and you're leading me from glory to glory to glorify your name. We thank you, Lord, this morning that we're not going to be the same. glory is changing us, Lord. You, your presence, your glory, your kingdom is coming. So once again, Lord God, we just say we welcome you into our hearts and into our lives. We welcome the change that you bring, Lord, so that when you come back, Lord, we're made ready and we're on that firm foundation that is unshakable. It's forever, Lord, and that foundation is you, Lord Jesus. You are on your throne in heaven, Jesus, and you're coming back. So we just put our hope and trust in you. In Jesus' name. Amen, saints.
Amen.
That's what we're here to do, is to encourage our worship. Our worship. In our worship, we have to allow ourselves to be changed. How many know, you know, many times we... You know, I'm 50 years old. You know, I really don't care to change anymore. We can get some attitude. We can, and I don't want to change. And there's continual, really, rebuke in the Old Testament where God rebukes the Israelites. He said, you guys are really stiff-necked. You guys have gotten hard. You've gotten stiff-necked. And, you know, this church thing is kind of hard, isn't it? This relationship with Jesus, it's hard. Why is it hard? Because it commands you and I to change. And I'm realizing that, hey, God, you've given us some things that, you know what, I just like to stay put. You know what I'm saying? I just like to stay here because it'd be much easier to stay here. Remember when God told the Israelites, you know, I brought you out of Egypt, you know, and things are probably pretty good now. You've experienced my blessing. But guess what? It's time for you to pick up your bags and move from this place. I've been thinking a lot about that because it took a lot of faith and a lot of courage, because at that time, the people that went on with God, they probably made a nice little home for themselves. Hey, thank you, Lord. You know, I've got a nice little place for myself. Thank you, Jesus. And just as soon as you get settled in there, he's asking you, okay, don't get too secure there, because I'd like you to pick up your bags and I'd like you to move. Can I get an amen this morning?
Amen.
You and I, we've got to watch that we don't get stuck in our ways. And it can be very easy to get stuck in our ways and just allow, when God wants to change us, just to get stuck and just stay there. And when we get stuck and stay there, man, all sorts of stuff, as we say around here, you get boogered up. You'll get spiritually boogered up real quick unless you're willing to change. Amen? And all I want to tell you and I this morning is when God directs you to change and shift some things in your life, it's because he wants more for you. Not necessarily material things, not necessarily the things of this world, but he wants more of himself inside of you. How many know the blessing is Christ this morning? It's not stuff. The blessing this morning is Christ himself. And so you and I, as God's church, we're pursuing Christ. We're here to follow the Lamb wherever he goes, as it says in the book of Revelations.
Yeah.
We're here to follow the Lamb. And so that's our worship. I just want to encourage you, get a relationship with God. Take it seriously. Learn to hear his voice. And wherever he says to go, you follow after him. And when you follow after him, you'll find life. You'll find true food and true drink that will satisfy you. But as a believer, guess what? You're ruined. Nothing else will satisfy you except for your ability to follow the Lamb wherever he's leading you. And you just take some steps and say, God, I'll go. I'm not going to remain hard and stiff-necked. I'm going to go and I'm going to allow you. I trust you, Jesus. So I'm going to give you my life. I lift my life up. Amen. And in it all, I just want to encourage you, in it all, Jesus will be glorified. Everybody say, Jesus will be glorified.
Jesus will be glorified.
I'm going to talk a little bit about you and I just learning to get along together in our Christian walks and making love the priority. We talked about Romans 13:8 last week, which was, owe nothing to anyone except to love your neighbor. And so we're learning as a church. I'm not here to stick you into a building or into a formal religious place where you have to learn a bunch of doctrines. You got to learn you know, what you got to dress the right way. You got to wear, you know, not wear makeup or put your hair in a bun. There's a lot of denominations that wear their hair up in a bun. I can tell you, I bet they're a part of this denomination. Well, they can't wear makeup. They got to dress this way. We're not here to do that to you. We're here to see Christ formed inside of you. Amen? That's the goal of all of our life. And as Christ is formed inside of you, somebody gets the glory, and that's Jesus Christ. We're here to glorify Him and Him alone. That's the goal of our life now, is to say, Jesus, all that I am, let it glorify You. Heather, could you get the offering basket? I forgot it. And so this morning, we're here to glorify Him. And so we're going to give to the Lord just an attitude of worship. Allow Him to change you. Allow Him to, again, just to do some things so that He might be glorified in your life. Who is this King of glory? Beautiful and matchless one. Who is this King so holy? live a life of surrender. Change us this morning, Lord God. Help us to be the people that you've commanded us to be. Loving you and loving people. I pray that in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
And amen. You can be dismissed, worship team. Turn in your Bibles over to Romans chapter 14. 14.